Well, good morning, Elena. What you cooking?
What's up, guys? Gabriel here, and today I'm hanging out with John Paul, and we have an exciting day ahead of us. We're gonna go on John Paul's lake house and get on his boat.
And Elena's gonna go.
You excited? So we got some breakfast going on over here. Ooh. Got some eggs. Can't ever have too much cheese. A little bit of coffee brewing.
And another thing we're gonna do today is watch the World Cup finals.
Yeah.
It starts in like 30 minutes.
Who are you going for?
I don't know, I think Croatia is the underdog.
Julieta, who are you going for? Let's go, Croatia, let's go. Cause I love to lay here lazy. We could close the curtains, pretend like there's no world outside. Pretend it all the time, no. And can't you see that it's just raining?
Oh, it was an own goal.
Was it?
Yeah.
Well, France draws first blood.
That was nice. That's how you get a goal. This guy was one, like, he passes it to him.
That was really nice. Croatia's back in the game.
Oh, I hate that, man.
Think he's gonna miss?
He's due to miss. Nope.
Well, that's halftime.
Quite a game. What do you think?
I think it's anybody's game, but France has gotten lucky for sure. Anyway, in the meantime, I got some clothes. Well, France just,
See that guy? He completely lost it. He was like, kicks him. The guy that was right there, that was.
Yeah.
So he just turns around and says, oh, there it is.
Yeah. Oh, come on, Croatia. Oh my gosh.
If it wasn't over before, then it probably is now.
Yep. I think that's game.
That should do it.
Dude. Oh my gosh. 4-2. Let's see if Croatia can make a little comeback here. That's the final whistle.
Okay.
Gotta give it to France. They were the better team.
Hello there.
What's up, dude?
Caleb, dude, I haven't seen you in forever.
Yeah, man, good to see you.
Oh!
That shiner line.
Hey, when he said he had an ice chest, I figured he had like a big ice chest. So like this boy needs to step in his ice chest game, dude.
I was like primed for the holding.
Look right who's here.
Better late than never.
Yeah.
What's up, dude?
What's up?
Dang, cutting it close here.
Cutting it close?
No. He's gonna put
dude,
something on top
like
of
it. It's like a
that.
Yarmulke, dude. We got everything we need right here.
Just so easy. It's a tornado. It's a hot dog. Yeah, just
compact. How would he be if I ate it real quick?
This is the condo.
This is the condo?
Yep.
We're gonna check in our bags and...
It's not a hotel, dude.
This is like the smallest elevator we've ever seen.
It's a 5x5.
1,500 pounds.
It's not a lot. My 2.5 for it on.
Y'all know what room it is?
No idea.
Well, this is the view. Pretty nice.
That's the pool right there. Like,
wait, are we
pool?
Going on the lake or are we going on the pool?
It's up to you, Robbie.
Why not?
Both.
That's the difference.
When you pee, when you nope.
I want to go up here. Oh, this is cool. Little bathroom over here.
Alright,
load
up to the ice chest.
Come on in! Ooh, the water is actually.
I've been moving kind of slow, no trouble with me. Trying to keep it peaceful is a struggle for me. Don't pull up at 6 a.m. and cuddle with me. You know how I like it when you loving on me. I don't want a diver them to miss me. Guess I see the things that they wishing on me. Hope I got some brothers that outlive me. Ain't gon' tell the story, shit was different with me.
What's the most Spanish I've heard him say?
That's our vocabulary.
He said cucaracha
the other day. But then I went to the cucaracha, yeah, you're right.
It's like taco?
He, like, his stomach is like endless. He can just eat whatever he wants.
I can't do that anymore, dude.
Dude, one time we went to Chipotle, he had two burritos.
Ooh.
Dang.
I can't eat that much anymore.
Hey, Oscar almost said a super monster.
I almost said a super monster. I shouldn't have had the Coke. If I didn't eat the Coke.
Why the fuck did you get a Coke?
Because I love Coke.
Okay.
Hey, you got snacks? Every month. She don't even love
me. She just putting on a front. You should start a reality show.
The funny guy, the dad, the good looking guy, the marshmallow guy.
The guy who we roast. That's so appropriate because marshmallows get roasted.
Dude. Yes.
Marshmallows get roasted, dude.
He's like, no, I don't like this one.
Dude, that is such a good nickname, dude.
So perfect.
Hey, why are you there? Can you get some sandwiches?
Yeah, get the snacks, dude.
Sandwiches? Y'all brought sandwiches?
No. I didn't bring sandwiches.
I don't know where these sandwiches are.
Yeah, I know.
Gabe, we're gonna take the boat and go get some food.
Oh, hey. There's a restaurant, that's right.
Well, why don't we just hang out here for like 15 more minutes and then go get the boat? Too rich for who,
y'all just got rich again. Fill it up.
It's a good idea. Sounds about right to me.
Which one's your boat?
That one?
That one!
That would actually be sweet.
So...
Well, if it was a little better shape.
Who can live on that?
Is it that heavy, Caleb?
Dude, I'm weak, dude. You can pick the weakest guy to carry this stuff.
That's true. Oh, it's between you and Marshmallow. So.
All right, take the weakest. Oh, we gotta go back to the freaking condo.
Ah!
Oh, I forgot the key to this thing.
Y'all can just stay right here with the cooler.
I already caught some beers.
Yeah.
I'm gonna hit the showers real quick, boys. Don't mind me.
Call me on my quest to find the bathroom.
So anyways, I've been living here in Texas for about 4 years now. Pretty cool. You know, I'm an activist as far as the water comes, so.
Yeah?
Yeah. Jet skiing is usually my main gig, but I dabble in tubing, so.
And philanthropy?
And I'm a philanthropist.
I guess probably my biggest investment lately is probably the house I bought.
Oh yeah?
Yeah, I got a discount. It's pretty sweet. A
couple million.
We were walking by those people, and I was pretending that Gabe was like shooting me.
Yeah.
Like a documentary. So like, they're like,
yeah.
So yeah, that's what I do in the morning.
I told them, like, so like, yeah, I've been living here in Texas now for 4 years, and they're like.
So what are y'all shooting for?
Huh? See, you
kind of a strange spot to have a.
Oh, yeah, we're just. When you gotta take a shit, dude, you always want home court advantage. You know? You never wanna, like, you wanna be on your own turf.
Yeah.
You must have really had to go.
For sure. Ready?
I was about to pick up the cooler. It's like, wait, that's not mine.
See if maybe I didn't even need to go back and get it.
This is ours.
The red one?
This one. Here.
That's not, like, it hasn't been used in decades.
Dude, this is nice.
I'm
to attitude, you can blow that shit right up.
I used to blow up these little like jet ski, like big boats.
Serious?
Yeah.
With your mouth?
Back in my day.
I think we should try. Why not?
Oh, this is what we want to use.
There's
this,
more blowholes.
This is actually the one we want to use.
But it's greasy.
No, that one's just for the top part.
Yeah.
Alrighty.
You guys have no determination.
I'm lightheaded.
Just if you get lightheaded, switch off.
This thing?
One eternity later.
Don't even really fit, but man, you know, I still had to get it for my boy though, you know. You haven't met your grandfather yet, that nigga a trip.
Dude, I cannot believe we blew it. Mostly you, but yeah.
Got some strong lungs on here.
You ever thought about going into the balloon business?
What'd you say?
I said you have strong lungs, you ever thought about going into the balloon business?
Well, it's slightly insulting, but...
Dude, it's a joke.
All right, who's gonna go first?
Robbie and Caleb, since they're the happy couple.
Fish out of water.
You know Caleb.
There we go. What we're seeing here is a very obese man trying to work extra hard to get on the floaty.
Two scallywags in their unnatural habitat.
Hey, you scallywags! All right, he said turn the boat on.
Caleb just lost his visor. He's in distraught.
This is my first time riding a boat.
Gabe is.
Whoa!
Oh
my god, we found the visor.
He
is. This is a guy who is clearly obsessed with material things as he swims to save his visor.
Robbie, get it! Robbie's right there!
Robbie!
Robbie!
Yeah! Robbie saved the visor!
Ready to jump in there?
Nice.
He just wanted to come this way. This is actually the National Forest.
Yeah! What was that?
Woo!
Are you trying to get it to stop? I'm trying to tell you to stop before it, and I was gonna blow it out.
He's riding down the water with his ass hitting the whole time.
Yeah.
What? Most of the time, I was just like, dude, my ass trying to be straight, and not like touch the water at all.
Oh shit, yeah!
Was it fun at least?
Yeah, it was fun.
It looks like you're having a blast out there.
Dude, I bet him a margarita that I keep my visor on the whole time. When he was getting off, he fucking ripped it off.
Oh, he ripped it?
I didn't rip it off.
Oh, you what an asshole.
You got video.
No, it was shaky. I believe Caleb. That sounds like a Rob move.
Who's going next?
I'll go with Oscar.
You want to go with Oscar? All right, you can go.
You gonna take the GoPro?
Yeah, I am. When I get on there, I'll put it all.
You got like a strap for it? Like around your wrist?
Not for my wrist, for my head. But I have an idea.
Dude, I'm getting a little hungry now.
Hey, it'd be all worth it.
Here, just jump.
Why would you do that, dude? Why did you jump in the boat?
Huh? Oh no. I don't want it to explode. I'm too fat. That
is something you want.
It fell.
What was that?
Oh, they're both down.
That was the GoPro.
Dude, when we were going sideways at the end, I was absolutely crazy, dude. The speed we hit, Like, I can't even, face planted hard. So, I don't think Caleb recorded this, but basically,
no, we
face planted a couple times.
Caleb did not record that
and
one.
If you're watching this vlog and you're wondering why you don't see any of the footage from the GoPro, it's because it just fell off on one of the times that I face planted. We were going so fast sideways, and when I fell, it literally ripped off of this harness here. So,
is that good?
You know, it's a little.
It happens.
It's a little unfortunate that I lost a GoPro, but even more unfortunate that I lost the footage. But it's all good. It's just things. I'm glad that we didn't die. Oscar and I had an intimate moment there when we fell. We basically face planted together. We went in sideways.
Yeah, y'all weren't.
And we just grabbed on for the first thing we found. We fell, and it was like we were just holding hands, yeah, and it was actually.
It sounds.
Yeah, it was pretty gay, but you know, and those like. Life-threatening moments.
You get gay?
Pretty much.
Dude, the lid fell off too.
Really?
So I caught it and then I put it down. It was
zoop. Oh, dang.
Overall, it was really fun, but really scary too.
Dude, it's so much freaking fun. Don't worry, I'll give you a good ride.
Dude, at one point we were skipping across the water. It was insane, dude.
Whenever I was turning?
Yes, that was the crazy.
You guys were like, zoom, zoom, zoom,
dude,
zoom, zoom.
I could not stop so laughing. Nice,
dude, we were going so fast. Like, I couldn't.
Gabe was like, how fast were you going?
I can't explain the feeling of like.
Because I used the G-force to like.
Yeah, it felt like we were skipping like a rock.
Parker there. I'm gonna get some fajitas at Fajita Jack's. To go. So at this point we're pretty full and exhausted. The boat ride back was actually really cool, really relaxing. We went back to the condo, picked up our stuff, and we went home. By the time we got out of there, it was super late and we were super tired, but we had a lot of fun. It's a little sad that I lost my GoPro, but it's just a thing, it can be replaced. I'm just glad I didn't lose this camera. That would have been like really bad. It was a good day and super fun. But that's gonna be it for this one, and I'll catch you guys on the next one.